الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ولقد أرسلنا إلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا أن اعبدوا الله فإذا هم فريقان يختصمون قال يا قوم لم تستعجلون بالسيئة قبل الحسنة لولا تستغفرون الله لعلكم ترحمون قالوا اطيرنا بك وبمن معك قال طائركم عند الله بل أنتم قوم تفتنون وكان في المدينة تسعة رهط يفسدون في الأرض ولا يصلحون قالوا تقاسموا بالله لنبيتنه وأهله ثم لنقولن لوليه ما شهدنا مهلك أهله وإنا لصادقون ومكروا مكرا ومكرنا مكرا وهم لا يشعرون فانظر كيف كان عاقبة مكرهم أنا دمرناهم وقومهم أجمعين فتلك بيوتهم خاوية بما ظلموا إن في ذلك لآية لقوم يعلمون وأنجينا الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون ولوطا إذ قال لقومه أتأتون الفاحشة وأنتم تبصرون أئنكم لتأتون الرجال شهوة من دون النساء بل أنتم قوم تجهلون فما كان جواب قومه إلا أن قالوا أخرجوا آل لوط من قريتكم إنهم أناس يتطهرون فأنجيناه وأهله إلا امرأته قدرناها من الغابرين وأمطرنا عليهم مطرا فساء مطر المنذرين قل الحمد لله وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى الله خير أما يشركون أمن خلق السماوات والأرض وأنزل لكم من السماء ماء فأنبتنا به حدائق ذات بهجة ما كان لكم أن تنبتوا شجرها أإله مع الله بل هم قوم يعدلون أمن جعل الأرض قرارا وجعل خلالها أنهارا وجعل لها رواسي وجعل بين البحرين حاجزا أإله مع الله بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء ويجعلكم خلفاء الأرض أإله مع الله قليلا ما تذكرون أمن يهديكم في ظلمات البر والبحر ومن يرسل الرياح بشرا بين يدي رحمته أإله مع الله تعالى الله عما يشركون أمن يبدأ الخلق ثم يعيده ومن يرزقكم من السماء والأرض أإله مع الله قل هاتوا برهانكم إن كنتم صادقين
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته My dear brothers, Alhamdulillah, here we are another morning, Alhamdulillah, where we are going to continue with our Fajr reflection. And we are in the middle of Surah An-Naml. And this morning we began from the story of Prophet Salih alayhi salam and his people. And this is the third story that was mentioned in the Surah. The first one was the story of Prophet Musa alayhi salam. The second one was the story of Prophet Sulaiman. And the third one is going to be the story of Prophet Salih and his people Thamud. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَىٰ ثَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا To the people of Thamud, we sent their brother Salih. And he said to them, أَنِعْبُدُ اللَّهِ He said to them, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, فَإِذَا هُمْ فَرِيقَانِ يَخْتَصِمُونَ And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, but they split into two rival factions, meaning those who believed in Prophet Salih alayhi salam and those who have disbelieved. Imam Al-Qurtubi rahimahullah ta'ala has mentioned in his tafsir the number of people who followed Prophet Salih alayhi salam, the total number was 4,000. The total number was 4,000. فَإِذَا هُمْ فَرِيقَانِ يَخْتَصِمُونَ قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ لِمَ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ قَبْلَ الْحَسَنَةِ Prophet Salih alayhi salam has said to his people this powerful reminder where he said to them لِمَ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ قَبْلَ الْحَسَنَةِ My people, why do you rush to bring forward what is bad rather than good? They used to say to Prophet Salih alayhi salam, let Allah, let him punish us if you are telling the truth. Okay, let Allah bring his punishment to us. Let him punish us if you are telling the truth. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ لِمَ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ قَبْلَ الْحَسَنَةِ لَوْلَا تَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ Why seek you not? So Prophet Salih alayhi salam has said to them, why do you not ask forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that you may be given mercy? قَالُوا اطَّيَّرْنَا بِكَ وَبِمَنْ مَعَكَ They said to him, we see you and your followers as an evil omen. We see you and your followers as an evil omen. So whenever something bad happened to them, they used to say this is because of Salih and those who followed him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالُوا اطَّيَّرْنَا بِكَ وَبِمَنْ مَعَكَ قَالَ طَائِرُكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ And then Prophet Salih alayhi salam, his response was, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will decide on any omen you may see. You people are being put to the test. بَلْ أَنْتُمْ قَوْمٌ تُفْتَنُونَ And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, the worst of these people. And there were nine. In terms of number, there were nine. وَكَانَ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ تِسْعَةُ رَهْطٍ يُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا يُصْلِحُونَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, there were nine men in the city who spread corruption in the land without making amends. It was said that these nine men were the sons of the noble people. They were the sons of the noble people of Thamud. And they used to spread corruption and in the land and without making amends at all. وَكَانَ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ تِسْعَةُ رَهْطٍ يُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا يُصْلِحُونَ قَالُوا تَقَاسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ لَنُبَيِّتَنَّهُ وَأَهْلَهُ ثُمَّ لَنَقُولَنَّ لِوَلِيِّهِ مَا شَهِدْنَا مَهْلِكَ أَهْلِهِ وَإِنَّا لَصَادِقُونَ So it was said after they have killed the she camel, Prophet Salih told them, guys, you only have 3 days. After 3 days, Allah is going to destroy you. So these nine men, they got together and they said, we are going to plot against Salih and his family. What are we going to do? We're going to kill him. And not only him, but also we will kill his family during the night. And then his next of kin in the morning, we will tell them, we are not aware of this.
We never knew what happened to him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالُوا تَقَاسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ. They said to one another, okay, they swear one to another by Allah that we shall make a secret night attack on him and his household. So they said, we're going to kill. And what was the purpose of them killing him? They said, if he is telling the truth and something bad is going to happen to us after 3 days, we should kill him and cause his death before we die ourselves. So that's one justification. The other reason was, they said, if he is lying, also it's justifiable for us to kill him. So if he's telling the truth, we will get rid of him first before the destruction comes to us. If he's lying, he deserves to be killed anyway. Okay, so that was the reasoning. قالوا تقاسموا بالله لنبيتنه وأهله ثم لنقولن لوليه ما شهدنا مهلك أهله وإنا لصادقون. And in the morning, after we kill him and his family, in the morning his next of kin, his family members, when they come out, the extended family, and they say, who has caused the death of our son and his family? We will say to them, we don't know anything about it. It happened during the night and we were all asleep. So that was the excuse. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَكَرُوا مَكْرًا وَمَكَرْنَا مَكْرًا وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, so they devised their evil plan, but we too made a plan of which they were unaware. Okay, so they planned. If you are plotting against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can never plot against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَكَرُوا مَكْرًا وَمَكَرْنَا مَكْرًا وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. They plotted and we were plotting it. We were also plotting, but they were not aware of this. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَانْظُرْ كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ مَكْرِهِمْ أَنَّ دَمَّرْنَاهُمْ وَقَوْمَهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. See how the scheming ended. We destroyed them utterly along with all their people. فَتِلْكَ بُيُوتُهُمْ خَاوِيَةً بِمَا ظَلَمُوا إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةً لِقَوْمٍ يَعْلَمُونَ. As a result of their evil deeds, Allah said, their homes are desolate ruins. There truly is a sign in this for those who know. وَأَنْجَيْنَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, but we saved those who believed and were mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's the story of Prophet Salih alayhi salam in this surah, Surah An-Naml. So what we have learned this morning is the following, that Prophet Salih, his people, 9 of them were the worst of them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them because they were plotting against Prophet Salih alayhi salam and his family before everyone else was destroyed. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he begins to talk about the story of Prophet Lut. وَلُوطًا إِذْ قَالَ لِقَوْمِهِ أَتَأْتُونَ الْفَاحِشَةَ وَأَنْتُمْ تُبْصِرُونَ. Where we also sent Prophet Lut to his people. And he said to them, how can you commit this outrage with your eyes wide open? How come that you are going to act like this and you are going to do this fahisha, this lewd action in front of everybody else? They used to commit what they committed in front of everybody else in public. Can you believe that? Subhanallah. So he said to them, وَلُوطًا إِذْ قَالَ لِقَوْمِهِ أَتَأْتُونَ الْفَاحِشَةَ وَأَنْتُمْ تُبْصِرُونَ. Or some of the ulama said what it means is, وَأَنْتُمْ تُبْصِرُونَ, while you know that it is wrong. While you know that this is absolutely a bad act. أَإِنَّكُمْ لَتَأْتُونَ الرِّجَالَ شَهْوَةً مِّن دُونِ النِّسَاءِ. How can you lust after men instead of women? What fools you are. بَلْ أَنْتُمْ قَوْمٌ تَجْهَلُونَ. You are very ignorant people. What was their reaction? فَمَا كَانَ جَوَابَ قَوْمِهِ إِلَّا أَنْ قَالُوا أَخْرِجُوا آلَ لُوطٍ مِّن قَرْيَتِكُمْ. The only answer his people gave was to say, expel Prophet Lut and his followers from your town. Why? These men mean to stay chaste. So these people, they want to stay pure. Okay? So they have admitted that they want to be, these people are righteous people, they want to stay pure, so because of that, we don't want them anymore. Get rid of them. إِنَّهُمْ أُنَاسٌ يَتَطَهَرُونَ فَأَنْجَيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ إِلَّا مْرَأَتَهُ قَدَّرْنَاهَا مِنَ الْغَابِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we saved him and his family. So the Prophet ﷺ is being taught, Ya Muhammad, if your people plot against you and your family, because normally these people, the kuffar, they do plot against the prophets and also their families. So they might do the same, but no, we will be there to save you and your family. So the Prophet ﷺ is being given that message. Don't worry. فَأَنْجَيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ. We have saved him and his family, except his wife, because she used to help out those who were against Prophet Lut alayhi salam. فَأَنْجَيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ إِلَّا امْرَأَتَهُ قَدَّرْنَاهَا مِنَ الْغَابِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَأَمْطَرْنَا عَلَيْهِ مَطَرًا فَسَاءَ مَطَرُ الْمُنْذَرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that he has destroyed them. قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now begins and says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say ya Muhammad, alhamdulillah. Say, O Prophet, praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and peace on the servants he has chosen. Who is better, Allah or those they set up as partners with him? I want to tell you a story right now. Are you ready for a story?
Yes.
Yeah. I want to tell you something now. The guidance that we have, Allahumma lak alhamd, no one's guidance is guaranteed. We have to be very grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for blessing us with guidance. We don't know how long we're going to have this guidance. This guidance can be taken away from us at any time. The question is, if it's taken away from you, is there a possibility that you might get it back? Or there's no possibility of the person ever getting it back? I'm going to tell you this story. The past few years, there was a particular person from a particular Muslim country. I don't want to mention any names. This person has memorized the Quran from young age. By the age of 9-10 years old, he has memorized the Quran. He has studied the books of Tawheed. All the books that we know that we studied Tawheed from, he has studied when he was still young. But after he has reached, after he became an adult and he was over 20 years old, almost maybe 30 years old, he has left Islam, even though he was Hafiz al-Quran. One of the questions when he was asked when he left Islam, he was asked, what is it that annoys you the most? He said, what annoys me the most is I cannot forget the Quran. He wants to forget the Quran, but he can't get rid of it. It is in his mind. He said, the Quran is bothering me all the time. Okay. So when he left the deen, so many TV channels used to invite him and question him, why have you left Islam? What would you like to tell other young people? Do you want to encourage them to leave Islam? So why should they not be Muslims anymore? So he would give them so many reasons. But let me tell you this, subhanAllah. After 10 years of being in a state of apostasy, this particular person, for 10 years, he was a murtad. He wasn't practicing Islam. He was against Islam. He was propagating da'wah that was against Islam. For 10 years, he was being interviewed every day by big channels in his country, TV channels. But what has happened after 10 years? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave his guidance once more to this person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided him back again. The question now, he was asked, he said, I want to say to everybody, I came back to Islam. And I want to say in front of everyone, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. He was asked, what is it that made you change your mind? Why did you come back to Islam? He said, because of the following verses. He's going to read a couple of verses. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, نَبِّعْ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, tell my servants, نَبِّعْ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. I am the one who is ever forgiving. أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ. My punishment when it comes is very severe. Also, he recited this ayah, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Allah, he read this ayah. He said, oh Muhammad, يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا. Those of you who transgressed, never ever give up hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah can always forgive you. Allah forgives all sins. But the ayat that really changed him are the following ayat. The ayat we've just recited this morning. قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. Starting from this ayah. He said, I made tadabbur of these ayat. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِهِ الَّذِينَ اصْطَفَىٰ أَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ أَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ أَمَّنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. He said, when I did tadabbur, reflection on these verses, he said, I could not stop myself except, but he said, I couldn't stop myself from becoming Muslim again. when I have made tadabbur on these ayat. What is Allah talking about in these ayat? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about His power. Allah talks about His favors that He has given us, that He has blessed us with. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. أَمَّنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَأَنزَلَ لَكُم مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً فَأَنبَتْنَا بِهِ حَدَائِقَ ذَاتَ بَهْجَةٍ. He said, these are the ayat that did not allow me to remain an apostate. He said, when I made tadabbur of these ayat, they brought me back to Islam. They forced me back to Islam. Subhanallah. So these are the ayat. Look, this is how powerful the Quran is. If the person makes reflection, reflects the Quran and makes tadabbur, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will soften his heart and the person can regain his iman. So look what he said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what he said. أَمَّنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Who created the heavens and earth? Who sends down water from the sky for you guys? With which we cause gardens of delight to grow. You have no power to make the trees grow in them. Is it another Allah besides Allah? No, but they are people who take others to be equal with Allah. Ailahum ma'allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks this question forcefully. Ailahum ma'allah. Is there another God besides Allah? Balhum qawmun ya'dilun. These guys, they take others to be equal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amman ja'ala al-ardha qararan. Allah asks this other question. Amman ja'ala al-ardha qararan. Who is it that made the earth a stable place to live? Who made rivers flow through it? Who set immovable mountains on it and created a barrier between the fresh and salt water? Is it another God besides Allah? No, but most of them do not know. بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ أَيْلَاهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ. Is there another God besides Allah? بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Majority of them don't know. So the majority of the people, they don't know these things. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَهُ. Allahu Akbar. Very powerful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks this question again. أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَهُ. Who is it that answers the distressed when they call upon him? When the person is in a distressful situation, when he calls and raises his hands to the sky, who's the one who answers that call? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you know the qibla of the dua? The qibla of the dua is the sama. When we pray our salah, the qibla is the Kaaba. But our dua, where is the qibla of the dua? It's towards the heavens. Subhanallah. We do this. Ya Allah, help us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, who is it that answers the distressed when they call upon him? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am going to teach you the dua of al-muttar. The dua of al-muttar, the person who is in distress, this is the dua they need to read. Allahumma rahmataka arju, fala takilni ila nafsi tarfata'in, wa aslih li sha'ni kullah, la ilaha illa ant. I will repeat again. Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah ta'ala has mentioned this dua in his tafsir. وفي مسند أبي داود الطيالسي عن أبي بكر قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has said في دعاء المضطر, the dua of the person who is in a state of distress. اللهم رحمتك أرجو. Ya Allah, I hope for your mercy. فلا تكني إلى نفسي طرفة عين. Don't leave myself to me, or don't leave me with myself, even if it is a blink of an eye. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves you to yourself, even in a blink of an eye, you are exposed. Subhanallah. فَلَا تَكِلْنِي إِلَى نَفْسِي طَرْفَةَ عَيْنٍ وَأَصْلِحْ لِي شَأْنِي كُلَّهُ. Ya Allah, you take care of all of my affairs. لا إله إلا أنت. And there's no deity worthy of worship except you. That's the dua. I'll repeat one more time for you to hopefully catch it and memorize it. اللهم رحمتك أرجو. فلا تكلني إلى نفسي طرفة عين وأصلح لي شأني كله لا إله إلا أنت. You can go back to the video later on if you want, inshallah ta'ala. So that's the dua. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised, if someone has been wronged, if someone, for example, was wronged and he's madloom, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, فَإِنِّي لَا أَرُدُّهَا وَلَوْ كَانَتْ مِنْ فَمِ كَافِرٍ. Allah has promised. Allah said the dua of the distressed, the person who has been oppressed. Even if that dua comes from the mouth of a disbeliever, Allah said, I will accept it. Even if we wrong a kafir, and the kafir makes dua against you, Allah will accept it. James Johnson, who has never prayed, who doesn't know Allah, who doesn't respect, if he makes dua against you and says, this person has wronged me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept his dua. And he will deal with you, even if you pray day and night. It's very serious. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's what he said. You cannot wrong people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's just. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that's what's going to happen. And there's another story that I would love to tell you, subhanallah. That story is a man who used to live in Dimashq. He used to have a horse or a mount that he used to let people, that he used to hire it out. So he used to take people, he was like a taxi driver. So he used to take people from one town to another. So one day he said, a man came to me and hired me. And he said to me, okay, I want you to take me to that destination. He said, I took him. While we were on our way, on our journey, the man had said to me, I know a different route. I said to him, I don't normally take this route when I'm going to that town. He said, no, I know a short route. Let us take this route. He said, I listened to him. And when we went to that route was not, it was a no man's land. Nobody took that route. It was only us. Until we came to a valley where I saw so many dead people. And the guy who hired me attacked me in the middle of that valley. I ran away from him. He caught me. And then now, when I felt that he was going to kill me, I said to him, like, you take my belongings, take my horse, anything which is on it, just leave me alone. Allow me to live and exist. He said to me, no, I'm going to kill you as well. I said to him, please allow me to pray 2 rak'ahs. He said, okay, pray your 2 rak'ah, but make them short. I said to him, no problem. He said, I entered the salah. I began my salah. He said, when I started my salah, I forgot the whole Quran. Because of the fear. He said, everything, I became blank. He said, I could not remember anything. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded me this ayah. أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ. He said, the only thing I could remember was that. أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءُ. He said, I recited this ayah. As I was reciting this ayah, he said, a horseman came to the valley and attacked the guy who was about to kill me. And he was killed. And I said to the horseman, who sent you? Who are you? He said, I am an angel that was sent by Allah to defend you. Very powerful. Ibn Kathir has mentioned that story while he was explaining this ayah. أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءُ وَيَجْعَلُكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ الْأَرْضِ إِلَٰهٌ مَعَ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you can see the power of the Quran. This particular brother now who re-accepted Islam, for 10 years he was away from Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave his guidance back to him again. After reciting these verses, he said, I could not stop myself from coming back to Islam. After I made reflection, after I reflected these verses and pondered over them, he said, I couldn't stop myself from accepting Islam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds the people, أَمَّنْ يَهَدِيكُمْ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds the people, أَمَّنْ Who is it that guides you through the darkness on land and sea? Who sends the winds as heralds of good news before his mercy? Is it another God besides Allah? Allah is far above the partners they put beside him. And the last ayah, أَمَّنْ يَبْدَأُ الْخَلْقَ ثُمَّ يُعِيدُ. Allah has asked, who is it that creates life and reproduces it? Who is it that gives you provision from the heavens and earth? Is it another Allah besides Allah? Say, show me your evidence then if what you say is true. Very powerful ayat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who take heed from these ayat. And inshallah ta'ala, I want to just say to the brothers, tomorrow we're not going to have the lesson. I'm going to be away. And inshallah ta'ala, tomorrow, as you know, is Thursday. It's the end of the week, the last day that we have the lesson. So inshallah ta'ala, tomorrow and Friday, as usual, Friday we don't have any lesson. And inshallah ta'ala, Saturday. So we'll be back on Saturday. And Saturday could be the first day of Ramadan, or it could be the last day of Sha'ban, one of them. So anyway, the lesson is going to continue through Ramadan as well, because we started last Ramadan. It was the month of Ramadan when we started. So we're not going to stop for Ramadan. Definitely we will have it, but we'll make it a bit shorter, inshallah ta'ala, after Fajr. So, but inshallah ta'ala, the lesson is going to continue. So Saturday will be our next lesson. And Saturday, inshallah ta'ala, we will complete Surah An-Naml. Surah An-Naml is going to end and Qasas is going to start, inshallah ta'ala. Jazakumullahu khairan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who take heed from the Quran.